One of the most interesting measurements that we see show up about 90% of the time is a measurement where someone is over-focusing in their thought processes on outward appearances, how someone looks. Now imagine a sales team member who goes out and talks to a customer who's over-focused on outward appearance, and they look like they're going to buy. So they create an expectation, they put it in their report, they're all excited about it, and then it doesn't materialize. Ever happen? Or you have the salesperson who has this measurement, who also has a measurement in self-esteem where they are minimizing their own ability. They're undervaluing their own ability, and so they show up with this negative self-talk about their inadequacy, focused on someone who looks highly successful, and they're intimidated to have the conversation. What's the likelihood it's going to be comfortable, natural? The person's going to be focused on stepping into the world of the customer, finding out what they need, creating trust, taking down walls of resistance if they're constantly thinking about their own inadequacy. This creates a real challenge in our world, because if we think for a moment that what we see is the truth, then we're somewhat deluded by the facade of the world. Nothing is as it appears in today's world. We are going to want salespeople to know how to listen differently, how to ask empathetic questions based on their experience with customers like the one they're talking to, create trust, take down walls of resistance, release cooperation and productivity. Now, we've all heard about solution-based kinds of ways of approaching, integrity-based selling, those kinds of approaches. The challenge is, if we don't know the thought processes of the salesperson and what's showing up in their head in the process, challenges show up in their ability to execute. We want to be able to measure, what are they thinking? What are their expectations? How do they feel about their career and job? How do they feel about their own worth and worthiness, ability and beliefs? Because all of those will play in to how well they show up, how available they are to serve the client. If they're in this space and we can teach them the principles of intrinsic validation, how to connect with and serve somebody at a high level, there's the difference. Every business in today's economy needs more for less. There's no question. We have been hacking away at the leaves of the problem. We've been systematizing everything, doing everything we can to get efficiencies and productivity. Then we come in, we measure thought processes, we provide principles, practices, and processes to create the shift, and everything that you've done really matters. All of a sudden, the people execute the systems with greater efficiency and productivity, and revenues increase.